There are lots of different types of note takers out there, and there are lots of different personalities that go with note taking. Today, we're going to dive into four traditional types of note taking personalities, and which one might suit you, which will improve and help tailor the selection of application you go with. So a big thank you today to Miro for sponsoring this video. Miro is a powerful tool for teams to collaborate together in real time, perfect for remote teams, hybrid teams, and in-person collaboration. Now, you can find the link in the description below, but we'll be using Miro throughout this video to demonstrate the personalities. So let's dive into these four personalities, and they are called the organizer, the note taker, the sketcher, and the collector. So we're gonna demonstrate this in a bit of a matrix and then talk about some apps that might tailor best to these experiences. So the first is the organizer, and the organizer is really what it says on the tin, somebody that likes to traditionally organize their setups, and this can be done through a wide variety of ways. Folders, tags, and labels are commonly associated with that type of organization. Now, commonly tools that are best suited for something like this are more traditional tools like PKM, and also like Evernote and those sort of traditional Nimbus notes, etc., that are more suited to having those setups and systems that are normally passed down through things and systems like GTD, Getting Things Done by David Allen. So if you are an organizer and you've already seen this kind of thing on the back of your mind, these tools might be best suited for you. Although do note that in the future, the traditional tools will typically probably grow out of organizing as a concept due to artificial intelligence coming in and making it a lot easier to make those systems and processes obsolete. But obviously, time will tell. The second type of personality in note-taking is the collector. It's somebody that just wants to collect things across their day, whether that's inspiration or audio, visuals, and things like that. And then what they do is be able to resurface it, be able to come back to it and find it for later. And this is normally through search and through being able to maybe even mood board it together and sort of find that in the storage. So these applications are probably more suited for those that are much more visual. So MyMind is a good example of a note-taking application that's suited to that. Evernote also has powerful search for multimedia, but also so does many of the other sort of platforms that are sort of very much fixated, like Dropbox, which has Dropbox Paper as part of its assisting practice. So collectors are much more to do with the finding of the tool, and that can help to make the decision on the tool to be able to work out whether the type of the way that you use it helps to match to the tool that you're using. So the next personality is the sketcher, and this is typically someone who likes to visually demonstrate stuff. This could be through flowcharts, diagrams, actual sketching, and much more like that. Now, there has been many different tools that offer an experience like this. Like if you're a team, Miro might be a good one for you, but in terms of note-taking experiences, this is commonly best for like apps like GoodNotes and apps that are designed around that sort of notability, that those sort of visual systems are traditionally best with iPad. But there are a couple of others that are growing in popularity, like Muse and many more that are really visual sketching. And it is also really not to take apps off the card, but there are more popular tools like Remarkable and Kindle Scribe that can help you visually demonstrate stuff and still incorporate that note-taking aspect. So if you see yourself a sketcher, these sort of applications can be really popular for that. I know somebody who routinely follows the channel, he loves MindNode as a solution to do flowcharts and sketching. But there is always Miro as well if you're looking at it on the screen and being like, wow, this is pretty cool. Next up is the note taker. Now, this is somebody who likes to use notes, taking quickly and easily, but also likes the ability to use voice dictation, text to speech, and maybe even some of the artificial intelligence features. And these applications tend to be pretty available, most of them. Like Notion is a good one of these, Craft is a good one of these, Mem also a good one of these, and they're all types of applications that are really designed to make you quickly capture them. Evernote, another good one, you know, Bear is a good one. They're the ones that just get it in and be able to, you know, find and source it for later, but they're the ones that are much more focused on the text element of this. this. So they're not necessarily about capturing visuals and documents and stuff like that, or organizing it in coordinated ways. They're looking about taking a note and building depth in it. And those are typically good applications to come along with the note taker, that personality and style. So hopefully you found this video helpful in finding the type of personality that you are. Maybe it helped to refine your process in finding the best note taking application for you. If you're interested in Miro, you can find it linked below, and we're having them on a fair few more videos, so do check them out in the link in the description. Thank you very much, folks, and I look forward to teaching you more about how to approach productivity tools, how to find them, and get the perfect one for you. Thank you very much, folks, and I'll see you very, very soon. Cheerio. Thank you very much for watching today's video. If you're interested in checking out some more, you'll find them here, and also you can subscribe to as well. It'd be great to have you here to optimize your tool. And if you're interested in our new email newsletters or our Bento application, or even Tool Finder, which is a new tool that we've created to help you find the perfect productivity tool, you can find it linked in the description.